pain is temporary. It may last for a minute, or an hour, or a day, or even a year. But eventually, it will subside. And something else will take its place. At the end of pain is success. You have to give it everything you got. But once you get there, I guarantee you, the world is yours. So work hard and you can have whatever it is you want.
This is a team when everyone is playing well that I don't think anyone can beat.
In the last 4 years, Metro football has got a new name around Oklahoma. I mean, we're a team that people want to knock off, and we're big games for people.
We were amazing. We were one of the best defenses Metro had. We had a great offense.
And it's like we can't make a mistake. Everything we want to do, we're doing. And it's just, we're on this roll that can't be stopped.
This year, we didn't have very good expectations from outside. And we came together as a senior class and just talked about how we're going to take it to people every week, and we want to be the best defense in the state.
I'm proud of being a football player at Metro because we go through everything together. It's like a badge of honor. It's like you've done this for 4 years. You've had Tuesday practice. You've done the scalding dogs, and you've done all the punishments. And then you get to put your jersey and walk around school on Friday night. It's like a badge of honor. I got through that.
Putting on the Metro jersey, I mean, it's a pretty big deal. I mean, it's a special club to be a part of. It's not like most sports.
It is so unlike most programs in this state. I know you look at Jinx and Union, their state championships, but I guarantee you they don't have the godly men pouring into them that we do at Metro, and that is such a blessing.
I mean, I can't explain how proud I am. The way my class has just stepped up. Ever since we were freshmen, we've been running scout team, trying to make the ones and twos better. Now, since our senior year came around, we just stepped up big time, and I'm really proud of everybody in my class.
Obviously, as a senior class, we wanted to do well and get far in the playoffs and stuff, but that was kind of almost a side goal to us being in each other's lives.
I think that when it got down to it at practice, we didn't really see freshman or sophomore or junior or senior, we saw a teammate.
I mean, it pays off on Fridays when you have a close team where everyone feels comfortable and they're friends and like no one feels mistreated. It pays off and gets everyone going.
I want to be that good guy that everybody can look up to and say, I want to be like him.
I want to be remembered as a player to always make the big hit and always be there and always make the impact play and always be the fourth down player.
I want to be remembered as someone who loved football, but not only that, loved people and had a lot of fun.
Being known for being a good football player is fun and all, but I want people to really enjoy being around me.
I can remember sitting in middle school, and that senior, that stud senior football player would walk in, and everyone's eyes would just move straight to that football player. Being that young and looking at guys like that, you just kind of think, I'm never going to be that big. I'm never going to be as tall as that kid. I'm never going to be as fast as that kid. You're that guy. Once you're a senior in the football team, you're a senior football player.
You have a role for every grade, and it matures as you grow up and get older. And it's been fun to have different roles and to do my best to try to fulfill that role and complete it the best I know how.
I remember my freshman year, Nussbaum told me, learn every position on the football field and you'll be able to get in. And so I took that to heart and really learned every receiver position and even some. And the more I started learning, the more Nussbaum trusted me to get on the field and do things right.
The work's never finished. I mean, just always keep on trying. Never let anyone get down on you because you're going to move up or you're losing some players. You got to make a name for yourself.
Find something that motivates you and that inspires you, and then go take it.
You have to know what your goals are and go forth to achieve them. You can't go half-hearted. You have to go all the way. You have to be fully committed to what you do.
Dude, go right now and learn every single play in that offensive playbook, because that playbook is like, it's what makes it gets our team going. Like, we run one of the best offenses, and like, the earlier you learn the playbook, the earlier you're gonna get on the field.
Everyone's different, but everyone brings something important to the team. And so find those things and build each other up.
Don't back down from anything. Don't quit because practice is too long, because it's too hard, or because you broke your thumb. Don't let that make you stop. I mean, injuries are gonna happen no matter what sport you get into. So just take what comes to you and then keep on fighting for what you want.
There's a smell to our jerseys that I always get, and it's like a Friday smell. When I pull into school, go in the locker room and put on my jersey, I smell that, and it brings back Fridays, and that's something I'm gonna miss.
I really now understand what it feels like to have this conversation now and understand that I'll never get to have that feeling again. Nothing's like Metro Christian football.
It goes by so much faster than you think. I mean, I said that right there, and you guys are probably thinking it's the longest 4 years of your life, but it really does go by so quick. Just savor every moment, just being a team, being together with guys that just work hard with you.
Unless I'm playing football in the backyard on Thanksgiving, I'm never going to be able to put on pads again, go out with all my friends, and be able to have a great time with them while just absolutely destroying another team.
Hearing the fans behind you whenever I'm watching offense or being out on the field and some kids flying around and making good plays, and just looking up and seeing the theme of that week and all the students just going crazy.
It's definitely a sad feeling, knowing that you'll never be able to go out there with your fellow teammates and compete at the same level you are and be that physical against another team.
I'm gonna miss it, but I'm happy. I played, I worked hard. No regrets on my part.
I'll miss putting on these sweet uniforms every week. All of our, I think we totaled up to 350 some odd combinations.
I remember times either getting beat or being flustered with myself, how I'm playing and hear my mom just scream at me at the same volume, the same stuff every single game.
Hit somebody, hide!
That's about it.
I lined up, and I hear the coach on the Okmulgee sideline yelling, "It's a tunnel screen, it's a tunnel screen." And then I see our coach McCoy call Fox. I'm just like, we got him. We're about to burn him. He just bites horribly. And then I take off up the field, looking over my shoulder, and seeing that ball go up, coming towards me, I was just like, here's my chance. And it just lands perfectly in my hands. I secure it and take off, and I scored the first touchdown of the game. That was like 50 yards, and I was just so happy.
There's a lot of little things that go on the line.
The line is something real special. It's like you do something right, then you don't get any appreciation. You do something wrong, you get yelled at.
Well, when you go up to the line,
you just know you're going to dominate. You know whoever's in your way, you're just going to plow right through them.
I mean, you do all the dirty work. You don't get any of the fame or the credit, but we kind of make the team work. Without us, it'd be difficult to make things operate.
I'm going to miss the adrenaline rush, looking at our opponent straight in the face, getting on the ground right in front of him, shooting off. It's the best feeling in the world.
Especially when you're in a 3-3 stack and you know they can't block you. And so you just go full force and lay them out and you let them know what just happened.
The kid caught it, turned around, and I got to put a pretty good hit into his back. And he dropped it and it felt pretty good.
I'm going to miss hitting people really hard, especially those big slobber knockers when you get up and you have no idea where you are.
Yeah, I like hitting people pretty hard. Whenever I have the opportunity, I'll just knock someone flat on their butt.
Ian Graybill, he caught a screen pass, and I was out in front of him and pancaked a guy. After making the block and seeing him fly down the field and almost get in the end zone, it was unreal. A lot of it's hard work, it takes a lot of time. But once you push through it and you see what the big picture is, when you're a senior and you're getting your last snaps, and you get to see all the accomplishments you've made and the progress.
It's such a good feeling when you know you went and pushed as hard as you can, and you get to play on Friday night, and it's a good feeling.
The brotherhood, you know, you can't replace that. You become a family working with those guys every summer, putting in the effort, throwing up, bleeding together.
Being in one room with so many of guys that you go to battle with every single week, every single day, you get close to people.
Being a part of a team and making each other better and just building each other up, and the relationships you get outside of football from it, are they'll last a lifetime, and I love every football player.
You know, thanks for accepting me when I came in as a new guy. You knew nothing about me as a sophomore, and for letting me join what you guys had, and for encouraging me and for pushing me. We really pushed each other spiritually, not just in football, but in the spiritual realm as well, being good influences. And I think they did a really good job of that.
To see Metro football be such a big part of my life, and now it's done, and now it's over, I'm gonna miss it a lot. The memories that I have will last a really, really long time. So thank you.
Gage Calhoun.
Corbin King.
Harrison Brace.
Kale Creed.
Greg Chapman.
Jake Dowdy.
Ely Wales.
Davis Froerich.
Nick Anderson.
Brady Rosser.
Hayden Hilleberg.
Luke Burchard.
Danny Burke. And this is Patriot Football.
Come and save yourself and take it on me.